Hello children, welcome to Mathematics Content Library for grade 9. Today we are going to revise the chapter Polynomials through its mind map. An algebraic expression containing the constants and variables connected by fundamental operations is called as polynomial. For example, x square plus 2x plus 3, x cube minus 5x plus 4x minus 17, all these are different examples for polynomials. Now we'll discuss about the classification. The first type of classification is based on the degree of polynomial. We know that the highest power of the variable in the given polynomial is called as degree of polynomial. And for each different powers or each different degree, we call by different name. That is, degree 1, it is called as linear polynomial, and the example is x plus 2. Degree 2, it is called as quadratic polynomial, example x square plus 2. Degree 3, it is cubic polynomial. The example is x cube plus 2. You can see that as the degree varies, the power of the variable is also varying depending on the degree. So this is the one type of classification. The other type of classification is based on the number of terms. We know that term means the algebraic expression in which the constants and variables are separated by the plus or minus symbol. They are considered as the terms. Okay. So, depending on the terms, if there is one term in a polynomial, it is called as monomial. For example, x, 2y, etc. Binomial, two terms. Example, x plus 2, 5 minus y, etc. Trinomial, 3 terms, example, x plus y plus z, x square plus 3x minus 5, etc. And polynomial, 4 or more terms, example, a plus b plus c plus d, and etc. Note here, we are not considering what is the power of the variable. We are just considering how many terms are there. So, depending on the terms, the polynomials are classified as monomial, binomial, trinomial, polynomial. And depending on the degree of the polynomial, polynomial is considered as linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial, or etc. Next, we discussed about zero of a polynomial. It is the value of variable that makes the value of whole polynomial 0. For example, x square minus 3x plus 2. This is the polynomial. And when we replace the x by 2, the whole polynomial becomes 0. That's why 2 is called as the 0 of the polynomial x square minus 3x plus 2. Next, we discussed remainder theorem. It states, if a polynomial p of x is divided by the linear polynomial x minus a, then the remainder is p of a. For example, if p of x is equal to x square minus 3x plus 2 is divided by x minus 1, then the remainder is p of 1. If it is x minus 1, the remainder is p of 1. If it is x plus 1, then the remainder is p of minus 1. The sign will be interchanged here. Next, the factor theorem. If p of x is a polynomial of degree n greater than 1 and a is any real number, then x minus a is a factor of p of x if p of a is equal to 0 and p of a is equal to 0, if x minus a is a factor of p of x. For example, x minus 2 is a factor of p of x, which is equal to x square minus 3x plus 2, because p of 2 is equal to 0. This we have already discussed in the 0 of the polynomial. The same example it is taken so that there is no confusion between 0 of a polynomial and the factor theorem. So we also call the factor and 0 both as the equal. Then we discussed algebraic identities. There are so many algebraic identities that we have discussed. You can see all the identities here. A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. A minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. In this way, there are so many identities that we have learned, and we have solved so many problems based on these algebraic identities. That's all about the chapter polynomials. I hope this mind map revision helped you to understand the chapter in a better way. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.